First thing I'm wary of is the Brazil team.
Yeah.
It's, I think, overestimated. They have a bad game. The whole country's in crisis. I'm wary of that becoming the sort of dominant story.
We've both been in that position where you go to a country, the host team is out after the opening round, and the World Cup just fizzles. It's still a global party, but in the host country, it's over.
Second thing I'm wary of, as I think everybody going to Brazil, is social unrest. I don't think it's hypothetical. I think it's going to happen. What makes me kind of worried is how far will it go? Will it go from protests on the street about not enough money being spent on education, too much money being spent on stadiums? Will it turn to riots?
Before every World Cup, we hear these stories. You know them. Like South Africa, we were all going to go there and get killed. And in Germany, we were going to be overrun by hooligans. We actually get to these tournaments and these storylines fizzle. Nothing comes of them.
Yeah.
I'm beginning to think that Brazil is going to be the first one in which this actually becomes a huge issue. Getting back to your first point, this is why it's absolutely imperative that the Brazil team goes far, because I think this tournament will stay on the rails as long as that team is in it. And now the third one, and this is an evergreen one, is refereeing in the World Cup.
Yeah.
FIFA works it to this ridiculous rule where they must bring referees from every country and every association. So rather than pick the best referees in the world, they try to spread out the jobs.
Some of these guys are handling games they will handle once in their lives.
Yeah.
They make one mistake and it has consequences you can't even comprehend. There is always the possibility that you're going to have another Byron Marino, the guy who refereed the game that Italy lost to South Korea in 2002, and everybody knew, watching it, that referee was spooked and that made him incompetent.
Byron Marino has never lived that down. To my mind, has been out of refereeing for a great deal of time now, but that's the first line of his obit.